Quite a moment today when dozens of survivors got a chance to meet and thank the doctors and nurses who saved their lives.
For some of the survivors, this is the first time that they've seen the UMC trauma team since being brought there. News 3's Gabby Hart is live, and Gabby, you spoke with some of the survivors.
Yeah, those survivors grateful to be alive, and today they sat down for lunch in a ballroom along with the doctors who saved their lives. A couple of them shared their stories with me today of both trauma and triumph.
On Tuesday morning, UMC hosted their annual Trauma Survivor Celebration. The purpose, to celebrate life and reunite survivors with the doctors who saved them.
So we're here to honor them.
During the event, UMC highlighted some inspirational stories of the people they've saved, like Salim Abikaram, whose one-year-old daughter Maya was nearly killed after he accidentally ran her over as he was pulling into his garage.
From the second I stepped out of the car till I saw her, I thought my life was over. I mean, you realize that nothing in life matters after going through what I went through.
Karam says doctors at UMC worked diligently to make sure Maya made a full recovery. Also in attendance was Jenna Annenchuk. Her son Alex Wigg was hit by a car while riding his bike to school in April of 2017. He suffered a traumatic brain injury.
I still think about how we almost lost him.
Now, 1 year later, thanks to the hard work of doctors at UMC, he swims, excels in school, and still goes out for the occasional bike ride.
I just feel beyond words thankful that we are where we're at and for the treatment that he got at UMC.
I'm so thankful to be alive and hugging her and kissing her and being able to do well in school.
And UMC says it's moments of appreciation like this one that make their annual Survivors event worthwhile.
We get to see them on a lot of times on their worst days, and this gives us an opportunity to see them on a better day.
Yeah, and UMC says at least 200 people showed up to today's event, including One October survivors. I'm reporting live from UMC, Gabby Hart, News 3.